Subscribe to Feminism in India for your dose of intersectional feminist content, and make sure to hit the bell icon to get all the latest updates.
Here's your news wrap for the week gone by. The family of the 19-year-old Dalit woman who was gang-raped and murdered by four upper-caste Thakur men in the Hathras district of Uttar Pradesh on Thursday requested the Supreme Court that the trial in the case be conducted in Delhi after investigation is completed. A three-judge bench led by Chief Justice of India Sharad A. Bobade had on October 6th called the incident extraordinary and shocking. It had also asked the Uttar Pradesh government to file a response on its witness protection plan and whether the family of the victim had access to a lawyer. The Indian government's failure to properly enforce its sexual harassment law leaves millions of women in the workplace exposed to abuse without remedy, Human Rights Watch said in a report. The government should urgently ensure the compliance with its 2013 Posh Act. The 56-page report finds that while women in India are increasingly speaking out against sexual abuse at work, in part due to the global Me Too movement, many, particularly in the informal sector, are still constrained by stigma, fear of retribution, and institutional barriers to justice. The Supreme Court on Thursday said crimes against women continued in a never-ending cycle in India. In a 151-page judgment, a bench led by Justice Ashok Bhushan said women in India faced violence and discrimination in one form or the other. Women continue to be vulnerable to these crimes because of non-retaliation, coupled with absence of laws addressing their rights and ignorance of existing statutes. Societal attitudes, stigma, and conditioning also made women vulnerable to domestic violence, the court said. Aparna Bhatt, advocate of the Supreme Court, and eight other women lawyers challenged a bail condition imposed by Madhya Pradesh High Court on 30th July, in which a man accused of sexual assault was asked to get a rakhi tied to him by the victim. However, the petitioners stated that they did not challenge the grant of bail, but only the condition set out to tying rakhi to the accused. Political parties in Jammu and Kashmir have formed an alliance to restore the special status that existed in the state before the abolition of Article 370 of the Constitution, National Conference President Farooq Abdullah said on Thursday during a media briefing. On the issue, the alliance will also hold talks with stakeholders. The alliance was formed after PDP leader Mehbooba Mufti was released from detention after over a year of the abrogation of Article 370.